Welcome to study session 14, Reforming Centrally Planned Economies into Market Economies. Introduction. In study sessions 7 and 8, you learn about the collapse of communism in Eastern Europe in 1989 and in the USSR in 1991. This collapse was followed by the transformation of those societies. In this study session, you will learn about how the Eastern Europe and the former Soviet Union, EUFSU, transformed from centrally planned economy to market economy. Objectives: analyze the structure of centrally planned economies. Discuss market economy. Explain the strategies for transforming CPES to ME. General structure of centrally planned economies. The socialized sectors, whether state-owned or collectively owned, are overwhelming in size. The state owns all natural resources, land and mineral, and almost all of the reproducible capital, building, machinery, equipment, and investors, and conducts virtually all activities in industry, mining, construction, transportation, wholesale trade, communications, health, research and development, and education. The divergent reform experiences of Eastern Europe, the former Soviet Union and China raised important questions about strategy of economic transition. China has grown rapidly since market reforms began in 1978. While Eastern Europe and the former Soviet Union have faced continued economic turmoil and significant declines in output, the answer to this has been found not in the strategies adopted and implemented, but in differences in economic structures. Although China and EEFSU were all centrally planned economies, their economic structures differed. The structure of Chinese economy, 1949-1978. China became a communist country after the revolution of 1949 and began its economic transition to market economy in 1978. Between 1949 and 1978, the main features of Chinese economy are as follows. Economic backwardness. Even though the agricultural commune was brutally regimented before 1978, it did not suffer the rigidities of heavy subsidies, soft budget constraints, and guaranteed employment of state industry. Absence of social guarantees in the countryside. Rural workers flood into the cities in search of jobs at extremely low pay. Less penetration of central planning, since less percentage of workers in state enterprises. The structure of EEFSU economies before 1989. From 1924, when the Soviet Union became a communist economy, and 1949, when Eastern Europe, up to the period of revolution and transformation in 1989, the economic structure of the EEFSU was as follows. Preponderance of state sector employment. In EEFSU countries, about 90% of the labor force in 1985 was in state and municipal enterprises and organizations with soft budget constraints. Unlike China, EEFSU was overwhelmingly urban and industrial. Too much heavy industries, too little light industries, consumer goods and services. Under central planning, the Soviet Union developed a considerable division of labor. This makes reorientation difficult. Subsidy. Virtually all workers before 1992 were in jobs heavily subsidized by the state. Overextensive social welfare system. Virtually the entire EEFSU population was covered by an extensive social welfare system, with benefits linked to place of work, job tenure, pension benefits, guaranteed income, health and housing. Deeper penetration of central planning, since most of the workers were in state enterprise. Market economy, capitalism. In money economy, there is preponderance of private property in the means of production. In this way, enterprises are not longer state owned, but privately owned. There is prevalence of commodity production. Goods are produced not for the satisfaction of the producer, but for sale on the market for the purpose of accumulation. in order to make profit and recapitalize profit. Transforming the CPEs in MA. The transformation of the centrally planned economies into market economies requires comprehensive action on three fronts: macroeconomic stabilization, liberalization of economic activity, and privatization of state-owned enterprises. Macroeconomic stabilization. Macroeconomy is the overall function of national economy. This is opposite of microeconomy, which connotes the functioning of individual firms and business organizations. There are various measures of stabilization of the macroeconomy. They include the following. 1. Fiscal policy. The program provided for a tightening of fiscal policy to restore a balance in the general government accounts. The goal was to cut subsidies to reduce expenditures and eliminate income tax reliefs, yielding additional revenues. 2. Credit and monetary policy. Ceilings on net domestic assets, NDA, of the banking system were imposed, allowing for a nominal growth. Liberalization of economic activities. Liberalization means the opening up of the market and sectors previously monopolized by the state to private participation. To achieve this, there are various measures. 1. Price system. Price controls were removed. Prices are to be fixed no more by the state, but by the operations of the market through demand and supply. Exchange and trade system. Foreign exchange could be provided without restrictions for most current transactions, as opposed to the previous system of rationing. Also, enterprises were required to surrender all foreign exchange receipts to the central bank. The authorities eliminated all quantitative restrictions on imports from the convertible currency area and introduced a unified and low, at around 4%, customs tariff for commercial and personal imports. Privatization of state-owned enterprises. Privatization means the transfer of publicly owned enterprises to private owners. It is creating anew the basic institutions of a market financial system, including corporate governance of managers, equity ownership, stock exchanges, and a variety of financial intermediaries, such as pension funds, mutual funds, and investment trusts. One key point in the strategy of privatization is that much of the privatization should be accomplished through the free distribution of shares to various groups, including workers, pension funds, and mutual funds, rather than through the sale of shares in an initial public offering, the IPO, which was standard practice in the well-known British privatizations. In Eastern Europe, the free distribution of shares would help sidestep the difficult, costly, and time-consuming process of enterprise valuation and recognizes the scarcity of financial capital in private hands. Strategies of economic transition. Gradualism. This consists of three actions. Agricultural reform should precede industrial reforms. State-owned enterprises, SOEs, can be reformed. Economic liberalization should precede political liberalization. Big Bang. This consists of four actions implemented simultaneously or in rapid succession. Almost complete price liberalization. Liberalization of the trade sector by currency devaluation to the black market level. A removal of trade barriers. Adoption of non-inflationary macroeconomic policies. Budget deficit is reduced. Legalization of private economic activities and announcement of impending privatization of SOE. Two track. Continued state control of state enterprises, which permitted growth of a new non-state sector, largely outside of state control. Summary. Centralized planning is implemented administratively through the issuing of direct command and extensive detailed coordinating instruction. The state owns all natural resources, land and mineral, and almost all of the reproducible capital, building, machinery, equipment, and investors, and conducts virtually all activities in industry, mining, construction, transportation, wholesale trade, communications, health, research, development, and education. China has grown rapidly since market reforms began in 1978, while Eastern Europe and the former Soviet Union have faced continued economic turmoil and significant declines in output due to differences in economic structures. Most state enterprise, preponderance of peasant agriculture, economic backwardness, absence of social guarantees in the countryside and less penetration of central planning were the features of Chinese economy before 1978. Preponderance of state sector employment, overbuilt industry, subsidized system, overextensive social welfare system were the features of EFCU economies before 1992. In money economy, there is preponderance of private property in the means of production. In this way, enterprises are not longer state-owned but privately owned. The transformation of the Eastern European economies into market economies requires comprehensive action on three fronts: macroeconomic stabilization, liberalization and privatization. Gradualism, Big Bang and two tracks are the strategies of economic transformation. You have come to the end of study session 14. Thanks for listening.